So this session deals with insertion operation. So how can we perform insertion of a new node in an existing linked list? So we proceed based on the assumption that we are having a linked list, we are having a non-empty linked list, that is linked list with minimum one node. So you are going to perform insertion in this list. So we can perform insertion at the beginning. So you can insert new node as the first node of this list, or you can insert new node at the end as the last node, or you can insert new node in between any two nodes. So this, based on this, you can have three category of insertion: insertion of a new node at the beginning, insertion of new node at the end, insertion of new node in between. So first we are dealing with insertion at the beginning. How will you perform insertion of new node at the beginning? So first we have to create a new node. It's simple. Create a new node. So in order to create a node, we have to take a pointer P, dynamically allocate memory. So when we allocate memory, the corresponding base address of the new node, so let it be 700. That get loaded in P. So assume that you have to initialize the node. So data part will get initialized with let be n. And it's not necessary to initialize the link part, because you have to link it with some other node. Or for simplicity, assume that you are going to initialize it with null. So this is what happens in new node creation and initialization. Now, in order to link the new node to the current starting node, what will be the assignment, pointer assignment? You have to link new node with starting node. In the sense, you have to store base address of starting node in link part of new node. So that can be performed using the assignment p link is equal to. So base address of starting node is actually stored in the pointer start. So just perform the assignment p link equal to start. So this assignment actually stores base address of starting node in link part of the new node, so that this link get created. So this is the first step. So first we have created a new node, link it with the starting node. What is the next step? You have to make new node as the starting node. So how will you fix new node as starting node? In order to ship starting node to or starting pointer to new node, you just need to perform the assignment start equal to p. So through this assignment, base address of the new node will get stored in the pointer start, so that start becomes now pointer to the new node. This is simple. So first step involved is creation of new node that we have discussed in the last session, followed by these two assignments. Now what about runtime of this insertion? Assume that you are having a linked list of size n. In order to insert a new node at the beginning, what you have to do is you have to create a new node, link it with the starting node, shift the pointer start to the new node. These three operations take constant time, and the cost of this operation is actually independent on the current size of the linked list. In the sense, you are given a linked list of size 5 and you are asked to insert a new node at the beginning. So even if size is 5, you need some fixed amount of time to perform insertion. Again, you are given a linked list of size 20. So in order to perform insertion, you just need to create a node, link it with the start node, shift the pointer to the new node. Still, it takes constant time. Assume that you are given a linked list of 1000 size or size 1000. There also, if you want to perform insertion at the beginning, just create a node, then link it with the current start node, shift the pointer, start to the new node. There also, it takes constant time. In the sense, this sequence of operations is actually independent on the current size of the linked list. So you can say that cost of insertion at the beginning is order of 1, big O of 1.